Well, that was a lot more fun for them than it was for us. I mean, we got beat in every phase, and I knew it was going to be a challenge, but, you know, we just they were more physical. They were, you know, the rebounding numbers kind of speak for themselves. I mean, we didn't shoot it well, so they had a lot more opportunities to defensive rebound, obviously, than we did. But, you know, we only had, what, 5 offensive boards to their 17, despite the fact they shot it better. So they outworked us, they outcoached us, they outplayed us. We've got a long way to go. I mean, we've had a rocky fall with injuries, and we're missing one of our 2 best players. So this wasn't an easy first game to play, having lost Jalen the last game. So, you know, it was Audrey obviously was our only offense in the first half, and Olivia, who hasn't practiced and played yet, I thought she did. Yeah, it's good to see her make some shots, because that'll help us hopefully going forward. But obviously we got some offensive issues, but I didn't think we competed at the level. You know, I thought we felt sorry for ourselves at times, and let down defensively, which is what inexperienced teams do. But South Dakota State's a really good team. They're really good at home, and they played well and deserved to win for sure.
You called a timeout after their 11-0 run to start, and then you guys went on a nice spurt there. Why did you think you weren't able to sustain that?
Because nobody other than Audrey made a basket. I mean, we missed some layups. I mean, we missed probably 3 layups in the first half that if we make, you know, it's a little bit different game. But we just had, you know, I thought they pushed us out on the floor offensively, and we didn't get anything going to the basket. I mean, we didn't shoot a free throw all night, so we got to be tougher than we were in that regard. But I mean, we're playing some inexperienced kids, and we're playing some kids who, we played basically our entire roster. So, it's a tough place for a lot of those kids. But I don't know. I mean, I think if the ball had gone in a little bit more, maybe for a couple other players early, then it's a little different game, you know. But I just think, you know, once we got to a point where Audrey was the only one who'd made one, now you're looking at Audrey, and, we kind of looked to her anyway. But in this environment, I just think we had some guys, or some of our kids just didn't handle the moment the way you hope they will later in the year and after a few more times being in this environment.
On the defensive end of the floor, you kind of started a little bit in the first half and throughout the game.
Thanks.
They shot a pretty high percentage. What was going wrong for you guys at that end of the floor tonight?
Well, they beat us up in the post. I mean, they do a good job of exploiting mismatches, and they've got big guards. You know, I mean, Macy can post and Tylee can post, and so I thought they did a good job there. But our transition defense wasn't. You know, well, there were a couple times where there's somebody standing wide open underneath the basket in transition. We didn't guard him, so. I thought they do a good job of making you play the shot and the dribble, which is, you know, South Dakota was that way, and so we've got to get better. We don't have great one-on-one defenders, so our team defense has to get better. But yeah, they until the final quarter, they shot really, really high. I mean, their final numbers aren't going to indicate how well they shot it, because I see they were 3 for 19 in the fourth quarter, but that means they were, what, 25 for 43 through 3 quarters. So they went from, you know, pushing 60% to, you know, finishing wherever they did. But we weren't very good defensively, but I thought, you know, it's typical of a lot of teams, when you don't score the ball, it's easy to let down defensively.